state bio. So good to know that we're not spending a bunch of city hours rewriting your bio. So good work. Good work. We appreciate that at the chamber. So Mayor Chrest, he was born and raised in Brandon's East End and was elected the 32nd mayor of Brandon in 2014. He served three terms on council from 95 to 2006 as councillor of the university board and eight of those as deputy mayor. Rick's love of the city is evident as he has always been a community booster and volunteer, serving on countless boards, committees, and organizations in business, arts, and charitable endeavors. Prior to his election as mayor, Rick has had a strong professional background in management, private business, and community affairs. As a matter of fact, he is a member of the Chamber of Commerce in his own right, as he has been a local business owner for many years. Particularly interesting as well is the fact that he served as the Chamber GM for 8 years, from 1980 to 1988. I was reading what they told me. Oh, yeah. And then Carolyn took over. That was harsh, sorry. I'm just kidding, Carolyn. She was. Yeah, there we go. Mayor Chrest is extremely engaged in all aspects of city business and the countless projects within our community. He is excited and optimistic about the future of what he calls Canada's greatest little city. Please welcome His Worship, Mayor Rick Chrest.
Well, Jeff, I learned a few things. It was a great introduction. Of all the introductions I have received, let me just say this is by far the most recent. So thank you. Ladies and gentlemen, I do truly thank Jeff and the Chamber of Commerce for keeping this tradition alive by having the states of the province and of the city. Last month we enjoyed Premier Palliser's address. By the looks of the audience, you have similar interest in the city matters as well. And so for those of you who are attending the fifth of these in a row from me, congratulations on your commitment to the chamber. And if I apologize if this feels, as Yogi Berra once put it, like deja vu all over again. I know based on political antics from coast to coast here in Canada, and even more so south of the border, Brandon Council is now seen as the boring group. Little drama, no backstabbing, just doing our work. But there is hope for our municipal level. ACC President Mark Friesen drew my attention to the fact that the mayor of Dublin, Ireland, gets 120 kegs of beer to use during each 1 year of his term. That's over 10,000 pints, by the way. Better still, the current mayor of Dublin has used up his allotment and had to add to the allowance twice. So sounds like being mayor in Dublin has a whole new approach that we may have to consider, ladies and gentlemen. I get to speak quite frequently to local students of all ages, which I love to do. And their honest and genuine questions and comments keep you both grounded and encouraged. Less than a month ago, we had 40 grade 1 students from Benny Gibson School in City Hall to pay me a visit. And at the end of my session, one astute young man, little grade 1er, with great certainty pronounced, "Well, at least you're nicer than Donald Trump." So I've got that going. Get such a reaction. Speaking of students, I'd like to give a shout out to the members of Youth Revolution that are here today. I think you can see them in the blue t-shirts. I've had the great pleasure of attending many of their events, and let me tell you, the energy and positive spirit that resides in these young people is infectious and a huge boon to our community. Moreover, while YR is quite well known here in Brandon, You may not realize that this is essentially a one-off, homegrown, branded program and not some national franchise we've merely camped onto. So kudos to Brandon School of Vision, their leader, Angela McGuire Holder, who is with them, the educators, and all of the hundreds of students who have stepped up to become the next leaders of our community. Congratulations and thank you very much. So I'm pleased to be joined today by my wife Karen and one of our three children, our son Brett. Local politics is certainly a family sport, and I truly couldn't do it without them, and I'm grateful for their constant support and encouragement. By the way, in preparing for this just last night, they did give me some essentially good advice and stated, don't be too charming, too witty, or too intellectual. Just be yourself. So folks, I've got lots to tell you, but I know you all have important work to get back to, so I promise I'll be as brief as possible, no matter how long it takes. I want to lead off by recognizing our council that was elected in October for a new 4-year term. We're away to the races with 8 returning councillors and 2 new members. Congratulations to newly elected councillors Sean Cameron and Bruce Lukey, and welcome back to returning councillor Sean Berry, Ron Brown, Jan Chaboyer, Barry Cullen, Chris DeJarle, Jeff Fawcett, John Laurengio, and Glenn Parker. I would also like to publicly thank their families and employers for supporting them in their council work and time away from family and their place of employment. And of course, we are very well supported by City Manager Rod Sage and his very professional administrative team and staff throughout our organization. I stood before you the previous 4 speeches and highlighted how collegial and productive the previous council had been. Well, I'm very pleased to tell you once again that with the inclusion of 2 well-prepared new voices at the table, this council is equally as collegial and effective thus far. So before I look into the future, let's take a review of some of the highlights of the past 4 years, or the state of the city, if you will. Continued fiscal control. 5-year combined tax increases total 3.25%, or an average of 0.65% per year. That measures up against inflation for the same period of 8.5% in 5 years, so we stayed below inflation by 5.25%. Comparatively, Winnipeg saw increases of over 12% for the same period, about 4 times that of Brandon. Collegial council, I already mentioned, and you may tire of hearing about it, but so, so important to be productive. Significant ongoing infrastructure work, closing in on $30 million in flood protection work, an annual robust schedule of renewal and street repairs, sidewalks, and underground utilities. We have a highly impactful community mobilization program which draws together a wide collection of local service providers coordinated by our police service to positively intervene for people in a highly elevated state of risk. In less than 4 years, they have handled over 500 cases and made a positive impact on the lives of that many families. We have a new airport terminal that has dramatically improved the experience for the flying public on a daily basis. We completely renewed the Sportsplex pool and track and field facility that has added decades to the life of that facility. The balance of the facility will be examined in the near future. We have found the means to significantly add to the investment here at the Keystone Center. In addition to the $375,000 in annual operating contributions, we have added an additional $500,000 per year towards their vital capital program. Our community has had increasing success in attracting major events, as you've already heard today from Brandon First, the Canada Cup of Curling, Tim Hortons Briar, Legion National Track and Field Championship twice, and a renewal of our hosting agreement for the National Arabian Horse Show, just to name a few. Also, we welcome the Wheat City Whiskey Jacks, our new baseball team, and I see General Manager Ray Walker here, and we're looking forward to seeing the first pitch thrown out in about a week. The Brandon Brings You Back program, the slogan that Graham spoke to us about, I think holds a lot of promise as a means of galvanizing us. I might add, I was a little concerned when I saw these boomerangs, although the imagery is brilliant. Brandon Brings You Back with a boomerang, but normally I'm fearing they're going to throw buttons at me, and I hated to see something far more appealing to be thrown. So try and contain yourself. There have been major improvements to the sustainability of the Wheat City Golf Course through major diking to protect it, and now a major condo, commercial, and recreational development that will start shortly. Great progress by many of Brandon's iconic partner institutions. Assiniboine Community College continues to expand its programming and develop its facilities, and it has a significant impact on training demands and fulfilling job market issues. Brandon University continues to gain in national and international prominence, which is seeing its enrollment grow at a steady basis. Prairie Mountain Health has a major impact on our region, and ongoing investments in the Brandon Regional Health Center and other facilities are significant. And Brandon School Division, who are charged with the vital role of educating our young people, have been bursting at the seams due to Brandon's growth, are well underway with the construction of Brandon's newest school, thanks to a major investment by our provincial government. Meaningful work on Indigenous opportunities through our Brandon Urban Aboriginal People's Council. This has led to a successful and positive negotiation with Gambler First Nation to create Brandon's first commercial urban reserve on Brandon's North Hill, the groundbreaking for which will occur later this week. City developments occurring in downtown Brandon, with many projects supported by our Brandon Downtown Development Corporation, BDDC, I see exciting prospects ahead, including a potential transformational project initiated by Brandon University on lands made available by the city and BDDC. Significant progress on the Riverbank Renewal Project, including the very exciting Festival Park event venue that will open early this summer. We have built another spray park hub at Valley View Community Center, which will also open this summer as well. But sadly, not everything in our community has burgeoned in a positive fashion. And like many cities in Canada, Brandon is suffering with several social issues, including addictions. As most will be aware, crystal methamphetamine is having a profoundly negative impact on our community, on the lives of those with the misfortune of becoming addicted to this substance, their families, and on many health and social service providers who are tasked with trying to keep up with this issue. Moreover, the resultant spike in crime in our city, which has included an uptick in weapons, has impacted many citizens as well. Excuse me. Well, health, addictions, and social services are primarily the domain of senior governments. Locally, we have played a very strong role in advocacy and support to our senior colleagues. Brandon Council has also added additional allocations to our Brandon Police Service towards illegal drug suppression and combating human exploitation that comes inherent with drug issues. On the prevention side, we have been proactive by creating the Mayor's Youth Addiction Prevention Initiative, now known as NEO, which stands for Not Even Once. It is a program that we put on last December in every high school, and we are continuing this program again this fall. There are many local organizations and individuals committed to this issue as well, and I'm hopeful that these collective efforts, along with the province, Prairie Mountain Health, AFM, BPS, and many others, will begin to gain some ground on this very threatening and troublesome problem. So folks, that's just scratching the surface, but certainly just a few highlights of the work of council, city staff, and our community over the last 4 years or so. Now a preview of the things we expect to be working on over the next 4 years or more. As you may be aware, shortly after the election of a new council, it is our practice to conduct a strategic planning session of council and senior staff. For our new council, this occurred about 3 weeks ago. The final report is currently being prepared, but I'm pleased to advise today's chamber audience and those tuning in on YouTube Live, by the way, new technology, live YouTube streaming, hitting the big time now. And with the permission of my council colleagues, I'm providing a summary of the areas of focus moving forward. Today will be the four-page teaser summary. A complete, highly redacted report will be made public in a couple of weeks. Just kidding. Now, I did introduce council to some highly sophisticated decision-making technology that was part of my household as a youngster. It's the highly accurate and trusty Magic 8-Ball. Again, this is another thing that ACC President Frieson shares. He's also an 8-Ball believer. So it should be emphasized that the City of Brandon has a broad range of extremely important responsibilities and services that have significant impacts for our residents. So while each and every department and the many day-to-day works of our staff and council will continue to receive robust and professional attention, council identified six strategic priority areas that will receive additional focus from council during this term and beyond. Economic development. Council would like to amp up support to our economic development department with a view to letting them focus their responsibilities more purely on economic development. Using the existing Prosperity by Design document as a starting point, we would like to ensure economic development efforts are a coordinated community collaborative initiative involving many stakeholders in a true Team Brandon approach. We will also coordinate with both senior levels of government and dovetail into the province's new strategy and especially target more strategic industrial growth, diverse jobs, and innovation. We look forward to engaging with the Chamber in particular and many other local stakeholders on this initiative. Recreation and green space. Brandon has just rolled out its refreshed Recreation Master Plan, which is an exciting and robust blueprint to improve the quality of life and the future of this community for several decades forward. In my view, and I believe shared by every member of council, while we have many excellent amenities and programs in Brandon, we have backslid in some areas, and it is time to commence new investments, new programs, and greater coordination and access to existing programs. The plan is bold and ambitious, but we will find a responsible and affordable means of phasing in new facilities over time with a stated objective of getting started immediately and beginning to knock some of these off the list one by one. Stay tuned. I believe we're entering a very exciting time towards a significant uptick in the quality of life for residents of all ages and cultures. Infrastructure, always a big area for any municipality. Council will maintain a continued focus on the maintenance and renewal of our very vital infrastructure, which will include all facets such as streets, sidewalks, back lanes, and sewer and water utilities. We will also continue the progress on what is our one mega project, that being the full renewal of our vital water treatment plant, a total capital investment that will be in the magnitude of $100 million when complete over the next several years. As an aside, on the topic of infrastructure, I can't help but acknowledge that during last week's release of CAA Manitoba's 10 worst roads list, for the fifth year in a row, Brandon is absent from the list. While we're not perfect, our crews do work hard through consistent maintenance and ongoing renewal to keep our streets as sound as possible for our residents and visitors alike. Social issues. While much of this category lies in the hands of senior levels of government, we will continue to make it a priority to collaborate with government and other agencies to help combat social challenges. Areas such as addictions, mental health, housing, and community inclusion, among others, will see our focus in community safety and crime reduction are significant priorities on an ongoing basis. Downtown resurgence. Council will continue the focus on downtown development, much of this effort channeled through the Brandon Downtown Development Corporation. We remain optimistic about the prospects for Brandon University's downtown development project, which could be a significant game changer, as well as other developments, both large and small, that we anticipate over the next several years. Support for downtown public safety will also be a priority. Fiscal sustainability. Whether we like it or not, tax control and fiscal prudence is probably a forever job for a responsible for City Council. We have a terrific track record over five budgets thus far, and this area continues to be a stated priority for our new council. We are constantly searching for alternative revenue sources to decrease our reliance on purely property taxes with a view to financial sustainability at all times. We wish to continue to focus on sound labor strategies to make the most effective and efficient use of human resources in every part of our operation. Two more categories that are not specific priorities: bold and innovative, environment and climate change. While not separate priority areas, Council determined that we will have two additional considerations that will overarch all of the priorities and indeed the vast balance of the City's work. We wish to instill components of bold and innovative thinking into much of our work as possible, and to promote a culture that considers the environment and climate change in everything we do. Ladies and gentlemen, coming to the conclusion, thank you so much for bearing with me and taking such an interest in your community. More importantly, thanks to each of you for the important roles that you play in the progress and future of our great community. I see a fabulous future for this city, and the energy, the inclusiveness, the caring, the spirit, and the progressive positive attitudes I witness every day make me proud to be part of this community, proud to work among you, and proud to be the mayor of the greatest little city in Canada. Brandon brings you back. Thank you very much. Have a great year.
We appreciate the fact that you take the time and you're able to address us and keep us informed with what's going on in the city. Two quick questions that I had were: a few years ago, the Chamber put a lot of effort into some policy work on rent tape reduction, specifically tied around our development community. I was wondering if you could touch me with a lot of our members that are affected in this room as to where that's at and what you see with that issue going forward with how the city and the development community work together.
Thanks very much, and that's an awesome category, Jeff. So certainly our council, and I believe our whole administration, is very mindful of red tape. Sadly, some of the things are not of our own making. We are the ones that have to enforce the National Building Code and the Fire Code, and so we have to sort of work within those frameworks. But an area that I see as having a significant impact is, most of you will be aware, it's been announced that the Brandon Area Planning District, that's been a long-time partnership between the municipalities of Brandon, Cornwallis, and Elton. It's been determined by the partners, especially the RMs, have decided that being kind of attached to the big city here isn't always in their best interest to provide the area that they probably feel most comfortable working in. Although we get along great, it's worked very well for many years. Everybody is going to end up in a place that probably is more suits each individual municipality's needs. So that transition is now underway. The two RMs, I think, together will be likely joining other RMs to create their own planning district, which will leave Brandon by itself. Not to get too bureaucratic, but the Act states that you can't have a planning district with less than two members. So Brandon being one member, we couldn't necessarily have a planning district to itself. However, the province has been very helpful, and they are very interested in now developing an arrangement, recognizing Brandon as the second largest city in this province, and recognizing the maturity that Brandon has achieved, and they are prepared to make us our own planning district, if you want to call it that. So we see that as the beginnings of a much more streamlined process, especially with respect to the development process, that all of it will be now sort of homegrown and in-house, and we're looking greatly forward to that coming, hopefully by the end of the year.
All right, that's great to hear. We know that's an issue with some of our members, so it's good to see that. Right, we're working in the right direction of change to make this a better place to do business. My second question is a few, maybe a month or two ago, there was some information that came out about an employment survey with employees of the city of Brandon, and right, it's lots of businesses know, right, your employees are very crucial to your business. So I just wonder if you could touch on what the city is doing to ensure that the employees are engaged and are providing the best service possible to your customer base.
Thank you very much. So I'd like to think that everyone would be happy that the city of Brandon conducts itself like a corporation the way all of you conduct your business and are in contact with our human resources, with our employee groups to measure their engagement, to determine where we could do things better. So city manager, you know, Rod Sage and his team, and it's a particular focus of Rod to be working on the employee engagement program, and they've basically launched quite a few initiatives throughout the organization. It's almost, I would see it on a sort of a department by department basis. I think Rod's taking the point of view that it's not a, because we're a very large and diverse organization. It's about 675 employees, and you just look out there and everything from people that drive snow plows to do planning to police officers, paramedics, and on it goes. So it's very wide and broad place of employment. So I think Rod believes that it's not going to be that one size fits all, and I think he's working within each department to allow them to put some of their own personal touches within each department. So certainly human resources are as important to the city as they are to every one of you, and it's an area that occupies a lot of time and consideration, especially at the staff level, but certainly is a great interest to council, and we'll be certainly supporting the efforts of keeping our human resources as sort of up to date and trained and engaged as possible.
You are free to go. Thank you very much, Mayor. We're happy to see to hear that those surveys are being put to use. Right? We do think it's important. It's just like anyone else in this room that runs or involved with the business, take something and be able to improve on it from there. After that, I can now officially confirm I also think you are a nicer than Donald Trump. Big round of applause for Mayor Chrest. And for the final time, I would like to thank our Lux and sponsor, Brandon First. Our new sponsor, St. John's Ambulance. And of course, to the Keystone Center for a delicious meal. Thank you very much.